As you can see, I have multiple artboards set up with Photoshop. You can easily create a file with artboards by creating a new document and then checking Artboards. Then, when you create the new file, you'll see that there's a title which you can change in the layers. When you select the title, you have the option of creating additional artboards, and each artboard can have a different size. Once you select your artboard title, you can adjust the size. The great thing about these artboards is that if you have a graphic that you've created, you'll be able to take that same content and then use it again in multiple formats without changing files. Here, I already have my new content on the social artboard, and then the other ones are from previous weeks. You can select the layer you want to duplicate over to another artboard. Since my text format is different for the stories board, all I need is the background layers. I'll duplicate those over and then change the existing titles. I need to refit that background for this new format. Okay, that looks better. And I'll use the same color for the text that I set up here. Here's another way in which artboards are useful. Not only do I need a high-res square social media graphic, but I also need a low-res email graphic. I could do that by exporting my file twice with two different settings, but I prefer to just duplicate the same content to another artboard that I've labeled as email. That way, I only have to export my artboards once. For my website background header image, I only need the background, so I can select the background layers, duplicate them to the website artboard, and then resize them to the correct size. Then, like the story artboard, I already have a text format set up for the YouTube artboard. Since the ratios are the same, I can duplicate the website artboard background layers to the YouTube artboard. For readability, I want to make a small adjustment here, so I'll create another layer on top of the background. And then I'll pick up some of this color to paint it in. Actually, I'm not crazy about how that looks, so I'm going to undo that. And change the opacity. Okay, that looks better. Now that the designs are all updated, I go to File and Export. And in this situation, I'm going to export in JPEG format. And the resolution is fine for all of these except for email. Since our email program uses a 600 pixel width, I can update that here. Then we export, and when we do, each of these artboards will be output as a separate file. Since all of these files are associated with the same week, I can go in and name them all to match. You'll notice that each file I exported has a dash at the beginning. That's because I added the dash to the artboard name. As a longtime Adobe Suite user, it took me some time to finally start using artboards. But as you can see, it's much more simple than having a separate file for each format. And I love that I only have to export once. If you've found this video helpful, please like this video and drop us a note in the comments. Thanks.